Good morning. Good morning. Happy Tuesday, everybody. I wanted to pop in here this morning and say hello and talk briefly about a huge mistake that I have been seeing and hearing as I've been talking to people over the last few days, especially. If you are new here and you don't know me, my name is Betsy Paik. I am a master NLP practitioner and board certified hypnotherapist. And I help women become unstuck and start to live the life that they really want. So here's what I am seeing. So how do I describe this? I have, over the last few days, I have talked to a bunch of people. And it's interesting to me because when I have clarity calls, if you are new here, you might not know, but I'll do a clarity call if you are thinking about coaching and you want to see if what you are struggling with is something that I can really help with. And get some clarity around that thing. So as I've been talking to people, there's themes that pop up. It always seems to happen sort of like in a wave. And I honestly think it's because as a collective, we are going through such similar things. And even now more so in our world. But what I'm hearing people say is, I really want that. I really want to start a side job. I really want to lose weight. I really want to have a really good connection with my partner. I really want, right? There's things that we really want to have. And the want is true and deep and no doubt about it. That is what they want. But what happens is when we look at the structure of our minds and how our brains work, if you think of it like levels, right? So if you think of the bottom levels is like my environment, my behavior, those bottom levels of my mind are the things I can see, right? It's the conscious part of me. There's an anthropologist, Gregory Bateson, back in the 50s, created this structure, right? This levels of the mind. And when we change things on the behavior and the environmental level, it's very much our conscious brain. So, you know, I want to have a great relationship with my husband. So what do? Like, I try to be patient, or I try to go out and do things with him or spend time with him, right? Environment and behavior. I want to lose weight. I really want to lose weight. So what do? I join a gym. I have a call in 15 minutes. I join a gym, right? Environment, and I meal prep, right? Behavior. Like, I do these things. But the models of the mind that Gregory Bateson describe talks about how once we get into the higher levels of the mind, they become unconscious. And those are things like my values. Those are things like my identity, who I really think I am. On an unconscious level, these are things like my belief systems. And so what happens is that consciously, I can only think about the thing that I want and the behaviors and actions I would need to take for so long, right? Before I have to think about other things, I have to shift and I have to move and think about other things I have to do in my day. So what is my brain designed to do in those moments? It's designed to just run a program, right? That's how come I can drive to work and not get to work and then be like, I don't even remember driving here, right? Have you ever done that? It's running a program. It loves to do that because your brain is super lazy. It just wants to make your life what it thinks is making your life easy. So it runs the program. So here's the mistake that I see all the time is that people will say, like, I really want, and I'll use weight loss as an example because it's an easy one. I really want to lose weight, but it only lasts a couple weeks. And then I start going downhill and I go back to my old patterns and my old ways. The thing that hurts me the most about this is because then what happens is they go, I don't have any self-discipline, right? I can't, I'm like, their confidence starts getting eroded when that's not even the truth. It's not there that they don't have self-discipline. That's not it at all. You could have all the discipline in the world, but the moment you focus on another area of your life, you're not consciously focused on that. And if the only place you are making change is consciously, then it's never going to happen, right? So here's the problem. People are trying to make change from their conscious, like, behavior and environmental changes. Then when it doesn't work out, They get really down on themselves. They start this negative self-chatter. They start to, their confidence starts getting eroded. And what happens with that is you start to make different decisions and make different changes. And when that happens and it's not in alignment with what you want, it's coming from a place of lack and coming from a place of, I don't feel self-confident, then those choices, those actions are not the actions that are going to get you where you want. And so it starts to create a lot of negative self-chatter, right? So now you've got this negative self-crap coming up. And then that leads to you reacting to people differently, right? Maybe snapping at people, getting frustrated, not feeling good about yourself. Do you see how that like becomes this chain of events, right? So here's what you have to do to create the change that you want and have it be long-lasting is you've got to change on those higher levels of your unconscious. You've got to change your values, your beliefs, and your identity, but even more so, your unconscious perceptions of these things. So this is where it can get, I think, a little tricky because what I have heard and what I've found is a lot of people say, look, well, I'm doing my affirmations or I'm doing my mantras every day, right? And although I think that stuff is great, those are actually conditioning tools. Those are conditioning tools to keep the shifts that you've made in place. To have an affirmation actually shift your unconscious, it's just going to take so long. It's going to take like 2 years. So if you can shift that unconscious piece of you, if you can shift those values and start to identify those values, right? Start to identify what you really think. And this is where it can get tricky. You know, I said yesterday in the video that I did that I knew that there was something that has been holding me back. And so I have an NLP coach. I believe in coaching and I have a coach. And so I actually hired him and I said, I want to work on this thing until I clear it. And so we did. It took me 8.5 hours with him on Zoom. 8.5 hours. We did it over 2 separate days to get to the bottom of what it was. And then by the last like 30 minutes, you guys, when he would ask me the questions that we started with in the beginning, I could see flashes of images coming up in my head. They were unconscious to me before, but they were creating an emotion in my body. So once I could see them, I was like, oh, I just saw it. I just saw that. And then we just cleared it. So it is truly about making what is unconscious conscious so that you can shift. Okay, so like, how do we do that? A couple different ways. One way is my dog, sorry, opening the door. One way is use the time when you're about to go to bed and about to wake up. There is a time in there where you drop down into theta brainwave state, which is a hypnotic state as you fall asleep. You know that like where you're really like almost asleep and it feels really good, or like right in the morning when you're like, I never want to get out of bed. That's it. So what you want to do is you want to start thinking about all of the things that you are as if you are in the final result of who you want to be. So you need to have these set up beforehand. So I'll give you an example. Like if I want to be a millionaire, okay, just as an example, I want to be a millionaire. What does a millionaire do? What do they think about? What do they read? How do they stand? What are their friends like? Where do they go on vacations? What do they do during the day? What's their morning routine? How do they, do you see how all the things? So in the morning, I want to start thinking of those things as if it's me, right? I want to step into that person as if it's me. So then I'm starting to program myself in that twilight state, okay? So that is one way that you can start doing that. So you've got to get really clear on what you want. You've got to get super clear on what you need to be and who you need to be to get it. And as you're walking around all day long, start to notice what your beliefs are. And that can be a little tricky if you've never done it before, but it is just starting to notice what you think is real, all of the things that you think is real. Now, if you want some help with this and you think you want to take this to the next level, you can jump on my calendar. Let me put it up here. You can jump on my calendar. We can actually go through. I can see if, first of all, I'll help you get clarity around what you're really stuck on and what I think the issue is. I'm really good at being able to see those patterns. And then shift, what is it that you'd have to be? I can also see if I can start to identify some beliefs, right? Beliefs that might be holding you back. So who is this call for? This is for somebody that's like tried all the other things. You're done. You understand. You might not understand the specifics, but you understand the concept of changing on a subconscious level. And that's where you are, that you're ready to start to move into that space. If I think I can help you, absolutely, I can show you how that can work. But this call is really about getting you a ton of clarity and me seeing if it's something that I can help you with. So if you want to jump on my calendar, I know I've got slots towards the end of the week. Just go to betsypaik.com /let's talk and let's see if I can help you. So, and if not, get clear on your beliefs, get a buddy, start to notice what it is you really think. It'll come out in your words, right? It comes out in your language. And get clear on who you would be if you were the person who. And then as you get into the twilight, going to bed and waking up, get into that, step into her or him and become that person. What does she do? How does she think? How does she move through the day that you have ahead? All right, y'all. I hope that was helpful. Thanks for being here. Thanks for being here with me live, y'all. And we'll talk soon. Bye.